Hello, BookTube Nation. I'm Sam here again with A Bear and a Bee Books, and today I want to bring to you my Victober wrap up. So, first things first, I had a lot of stuff I wanted to read during Victober, and I did succeed in quite a bit, but there are some things that I'm still reading that I haven't had a chance to finish. I hope everyone had a lovely Victober if you were able to participate. I just want to say a quick thank you if any of the hosts are watching my video. First, thank you for that, and thank you so much for this readathon. I thoroughly look forward to it every year. For me, there's definitely something special about the Victorians, so I always love feeling like I'm spending a little time with them. What did I end up reading? So I finished I finished two children's novels, I finished two novellas, and I finished two plays. So all in all, six items is pretty good. I'm quite pleased with that. Last year I read two novels, so they might have been I think I read more pages this year, but those were two full works, and I read some smaller works this year. First, I want to just briefly talk about the group reads. We read plays, The Importance of Being Earnest by Oscar Wilde, and also A Woman of No Importance, also by Oscar Wilde. And I have to say, I was pleasantly surprised. I haven't really read plays since school, which was a while ago. And I actually found it really enjoyable to read his plays in this format. I do like to go to plays, but I hadn't read them in a long time. So that was kind of a nice change of pace for me. Also, confession time, I think I've mentioned this once on my channel before. I know a lot of people love his novel, and I read it when I was in high school. So it's been a long time. But I really didn't like it, so I need to give it another chance one day. But going into that, knowing that, I was a little hesitant about these, but I found these to be thoroughly enjoyable. For me, I liked the second one better, though The Importance of Being Earnest was really it was really well told. It was a quick, fast-paced kind of read. But I really enjoyed The Woman of No Importance. I found that the discussion on, the fallen woman, and I thought it was really interesting how they were discussing, even back then, Victorian times, how women and men were treated to a different standard based on, different actions that they had engaged in. And so, I found it really interesting to see that pointed out. And also how forgiving Wilde was to the females in his story. In modern times, is not looked at that way anymore. But men of his time, I think, definitely would have had a different opinion to him. But maybe that's not true. Maybe more Victorians were more forward thinking, and it's just maybe I need to do some more research on that. But anyway, I found it thoroughly enjoyable, and I would definitely recommend them if you haven't tried them. This is the Oxford English, the Oxford World Classics edition. This is the Oxford English Drama, Oscar Wilde, The Importance of Being Earnest, and other plays. I really like these editions. I feel like they're a little bit more solid. I know a lot of people like the floppy, and they're not really floppy, but I don't know. I feel like when I hold it, it's kind of solid in my hands. I believe Katie mentioned she doesn't like, from Books and Things, she mentioned that she didn't really like the font in these. I don't know if I can show you that a little bit there so you can kind of get an idea of what it looks like, if it'll focus. But it doesn't bother me, and I like these. I have a couple other editions, and I had thought about maybe doing a video about that in the future so you can see like the different editions for the different classics and just kind of more particulars about like font, feel, pages. These pages feel a little bit thicker to me than some of the other editions I have. So anyway, I like these. I find them comfortable to read out of, and I would recommend both of the plays. The challenges that this can count for are Katie's challenge, because they were below 250 pages, so check. And this also can count for Katie's challenge, because it's also below 250 pages. But of course, this is Alice's Adventures in Wonderland by Lewis Carroll, and I love fairy tales. I even do host like a fairy tale-a-thon, read-a-thon here on BookTube, but I had not read this, and I'm glad I did. I really enjoyed it. I did it as a read-aloud for my daughter, and it's kind of like that debate, right? Like, was he a genius, or is it just a bunch of babble? but I really enjoyed it. I found myself thinking about a lot of different things while I was reading it. It's kind of a nice read because you can kind of let your mind wander and you don't feel like you've missed anything because it's very nonsensical anyway. And I tend to think kind of in circles anyway. So it was really good for me and I really enjoyed it. And I want to read Through the Looking Glass as well. And this is definitely something I will reread in the future. And the other children's novel that I finished was actually the last thing I finished for Victober. And this is The Children of the New Forest. And this is by Captain Marriott. And this was for Lucy's Challenge. So Lucy's Challenge was to pick a lesser known work from the same, that was published in the same year as your favorite Victorian book. So my favorite Victorian book I went with was Wuthering Heights because that was one of the first classics I ever read that I really loved and I felt like, oh wow, like I could really get into this. So, and I still like, I read that 20 something years ago and I can still picture like the moors in my head and just the pain and the heartache and like the passion and the drama. That anyway, it's a good book, read it if you haven't, but I need to reread it. So anyway, but I read this and I really enjoyed this. So at the end, there is kind of a bit of like info dumping and just like, this is what happened to everyone. But no spoilers. If you enjoy settings, which I really do, and you like kind of more rural setting, you may really enjoy this because most of the whole book is set in the New Forest. The basics plot of this is that there's these four children and they have to leave their home because of political upheaval and they're taken to the New Forest and then they start to live out their lives there as they grow up. It was really enjoyable. I found, not all the characters are fully developed, but the ones that were, I found them really interesting. And I liked how it showed how strong that children can be. Because I think a lot of times, in more modern times, maybe children aren't given enough credit. Because I think given difficult situations, I think that a lot of kids could really step up to the plate and do what had to be done. If you enjoy reading about like nature and if you enjoy children's literature, I would definitely give this a try. Okay, next, I finished in the Cranford Chronicles. I finished Mr. Harrison's Confessions by Elizabeth Gaskell. And I really enjoyed it. I kind of feel bad for Mr. Harrison. Just a quick synopsis. It's about this doctor, surgeon, and he moves to this new town. And he's getting kind of indoctrinated into the goings of things. And like all these women start to pay him attention and he gets himself into a situation, but I don't want to say anymore, but you can see I'm still laughing. Like I felt so bad for him. It's just so ridiculous. And he just feels so bad and he gets into such a situation. And anyway, Gaskell's really wonderful about writing about day-to-day life, which I really love. So I think that if you like, day-to-day life and if you like books that take place in like English villages, then this might be something for you. I thoroughly enjoyed it and I definitely am going to continue with this collection. For Angie's Challenge, I did complete to read a female Victorian author. I have read Elizabeth Gaskell before, so I don't get the bonus points, but I did read from a female author. So the next book I read by Elizabeth Gaskell is a novella called Lois the Witch. And this was one of the first things I read during the month of October. I was really feeling like I also wanted to incorporate some like gothic spooky reads because I live in the States and Halloween is it's kind of still a big deal here. So I wanted to participate. And I'm originally from New England, so something about the Salem witch trials definitely sounded like it would be right up my alley. And I was right. I really enjoyed it. I found it really interesting. And it had me thinking a lot about like hysteria and how the mind can really change your view of things. Especially like the mob mentality and how that can develop and how it can kind of run away with itself. It was also an interesting look at like religion and religious views. I'm a person of faith myself, but I, you know, obviously in the modern day, we look at things differently than they would have back then. You know, we know different things that weren't known then as far as like with modern science and medicine and things like that. But yeah, I just found it really intriguing and also completely disturbing. I wouldn't say necessarily that I enjoyed it, but I'm glad I read it. And it was a really, if you're looking for kind of like a pacey gothic read, it's really interesting. So just a basic synopsis for that one. It's about a lady named Lois who comes from England to live with some of her relations here in America, and things go incredibly wrong. Like I said, it's set around the Salem witch trials, so yep, enough said. But anyway, I would recommend it if you're interested in gothic Victorian literature. So now let's talk things that I'm reading, things that I kind of started, didn't finish. Let's talk about that. So first is I'm almost done with Cranford. I have a little bit more to go in there, less than 100 pages. So I'm definitely going to finish that. I'm really enjoying it. I like daily life stuff and I like domestic novels. So it's a really good fit for me. I always enjoy that where you feel like you're kind of looking into a window on someone's life about reading. Like, so if you like that kind of thing, I think that you might really enjoy Cranford. And then My Lady Ludlow is the last story in this, and I plan on finishing that as well. So I'm looking forward to that one. But yeah, I'm really enjoying Cranford so far. I love Elizabeth Gaskell. I say she's probably one of my top five authors. I've only read three things by her so far, and most of Cranford. But I just, you know, like when you read something and it feels like it's like you're like in the right lane, you know, like I don't need to change lanes. I'm good here. But yeah, so I'm so excited to have more to read by her. I really enjoy reading short stories and novellas. So she has a lot of those. And yeah, I look forward to continuing my Gaskell journey. And then I also got a fair way into, I'm around page 168, 169, of Deerbrook by Harriet Martineau. And I was really enjoying this. I heard a little bit of the plot, so that kind of slowed me down a little bit. But this is really quite lovely. I think that if you like Elizabeth Gaskell, you'll enjoy this. It's basically about two sisters who they lose their family, and then they have to go visit with some of their other distant family in a town, and it's about like what's going to happen to them after the death of their father and, you know, how things continue from there. The characters are really interesting. I really found there is a school teacher. She's kind of like a governess, but she's more, they have like a schoolhouse between the two families and she instructs the children there. And I found the development of her character thoroughly enjoyable. I found it really detailed, and I found that the way that it describes her emotions was so gripping. Like I could imagine knowing that lady. Which I thought was really well done in this. So yeah, so that's Deerbrook. And then I was like itching to start a Dickens, and I started reading on my phone on one of my online services, Dombey and Son, which I'm not very far into. I'm really enjoying. The reason I'm not like reading too fast on that one is because I'm determining whether or not I want to get the physical book and read that versus reading it on my phone, so I'll see. My eyes have been a little wonky lately. Oh, and then I also started recently another, is supposed to be gothic, story by George Eliot called The Lifted Veil, and I was trying to squeeze that one in before October ended, but I didn't finish. But I am enjoying it. It's interesting. It kind of plays on like mental health and having visions and having intuition, and it's all very like, you definitely don't really know if you can trust the narrator, but I've never read anything by her before and I've heard mixed things, so I wanted to try a short story before I tried one of her larger novels. So I'm enjoying that, and that is The Lifted Veil by George Eliot. And then I read a lot of books at the same time. I find I read a lot more that way, but I do get distracted easily. Oh, I'd never read a Hardy either, so I started Under the Greenwood Tree, which I've heard from people that really love Hardy that that's not his best, but I was looking for a shorter novel to try and squeeze in for the month readathon, so I started that one, but I didn't get very far, so I may just put that one aside for now and maybe start with a different Hardy instead. I love nature writing, but I don't know if he's for me yet. I have to kind of give it a little bit better chance there, so we'll see on that. I do have Far From the Maddening Crowd here, and I also have Tess of the D'Urbervilles, but I've heard that that's not a good spot to start, but that Far From the Maddening Crowd is, so maybe I will start there. That's probably one of his most famous. So so I ended up 1, 2, 3, and then the novella plus the Lois the Witch I read on my phone. I had a really good Victober. I felt like I got a lot of reading in, and I felt like I got a feel for some more authors, and I'm excited. I don't know about anybody else, but during the holidays, I really enjoy reading classics. I feel like, because it's the time of year that we're most nostalgic, and there's a lot of like family time and different things like that, I feel like classics are really appropriate for this time of year. But you know, that's just me. They're good all year round too. So anyway, if you read any of these books, you want to read any of these books, or if you want to let me know what your favorite book from Victober was, please let me know down below. My favorite one that I finished was probably The Children of the New Forest, which is good because I had never heard of that, and if it wasn't for Lucy's Challenge, I probably never would have read it. So I really enjoyed that one, and will definitely share it with my daughter again in the future. So with that one though, just, you know, it goes with the times, so it's not modern, right? Like, there's a lot of ideals in there that are not okay today, so there's that. But it was a thoroughly enjoyable read. So yeah, so that's all I have for you today. I hope that you're having a wonderful holiday season so far, and I hope that you're having a wonderful reading year. Thanks for being here with me today. Farewell for now. Bye-bye.